Hi friends, it's Jennifer from Live, Laugh, Love to Read. Today I am doing a book review on What You Wish For by Catherine Center. Now I got this on my Kindle. It's an uncorrected digital galley from NetGalley, so I don't have a picture, so I'm just going to show you this one on my phone. And this book was really good. I'm giving this book 4.5 stars. The only reason this book isn't getting 5 stars for me is because I kind of felt like there was some a little bit too much repetition in it. Yeah. I don't want to give too much away, but I'm going to say I thought there was a little bit too much repetition, and that's why it's not getting 5 stars. But 4.5 stars, it was really good. So I'm going to read you the synopsis off of Goodreads, and then we're going to talk about it. Let's see if I can find it. Let's see, right here. Okay, so says Samantha Casey loves everything about her job as an elementary school librarian on the sunny, historic island of Galveston, Texas. The goofy kids, the stately Victorian building, the butterfly garden. But when the school suddenly loses its beloved principal, it turns out his replacement will be none other than Duncan Carpenter, a former unrequited crush of Sam's from many years before. So Samantha Casey, who goes by Sam, is the librarian at this really cool, funky private elementary school on the island of Galveston, Texas, which I found pretty cool because I've been to Galveston several times. Every time we take a cruise, that's where we go out of. So I was so interested in this book when I found out that's where it was set, because when I was reading it, I was recognizing a lot of the places that she was talking about. So like the Pleasure Pier, and the seawall, and just all kinds of references that I actually knew what she was talking about. So that was pretty cool. So when Duncan shows up as her new boss, though, he's nothing like the sweet teacher she once swooned over. He's become stiff and humorless and obsessed with school safety. Now, with Duncan determined to destroy everything Sam loves about her school in the name of security and turn it into nothing short of a prison, Sam has to stand up for everyone she cares about before the school that's become her home is gone for good. Yeah. So the first part of this book I was struggling with. I was kind of like, I don't know. I love all of Catherine Center's books, and I'm just not into this one, really. I mean, like, the beginning. But I kept reading because, you know, we are all in quarantine right now. And I thought, you know what? Hey, why not? Let's just keep reading. And I'm glad I did because it turned out to be really good. I really enjoyed it. So Sam, like I said, she's the librarian. Now, the way she knows Duncan is she used to work at a different school. I want to say it was Anderson Elementary. It was even in a different state. When she worked there, she was very mousy, very just toned down, just very blah, you know, kind of shy. And Duncan was the class clown, but he was a teacher and he was a coach, and he was very, very much the class clown. He would show up in costumes when it wasn't Halloween. He would have like all the kids come out into the courtyard and everybody's blowing bubbles, or he would do handstands. You know, he was just the class clown. So when he showed, and she had this major crush on him, and never ever asked him out, never told him how she felt, but she was basically in love with him, but never said a word. Well, she left that school and went to Galveston, Texas, and remade herself, basically. So now she wears the, like, a red, instance of what she might wear for the day. She would wear, like, a red sweater with a blue polka-dotted sweater over it. And then she would wear a green headband and clown socks. And she's very colorful. And she has pink bangs now. And all of this comes from her mentor, Max, who in the very beginning of the book dies. But him and his wife own the school. Anyway, he has told her, you need to choose joy. You need to grab joy and choose joy every day. And that's what she has chosen to do. So she has remade herself. So when Duncan comes to the school, he doesn't act like he recognizes her or anything. And she's devastated, you know. But then he's different. So he's very stern. He's very, he's changing everything, adding all these rules and regulations. And stuff for security, he says, your school is so not secure, blah, blah, and all that. Yeah. So, of course, this book is a, I would say it is a romance because the story is all about Sam and Duncan, mainly. It does have that backstory of Sam's relationship with Max and Babette, which is his wife. She has, basically, they have brought her into their family because she doesn't have any family. So, but anyway, this was a really good book, 4.5 stars. I would definitely recommend it. That doesn't come out until July, but like I said, I read it on NetGalley. And so I want to thank Catherine Center and NetGalley for the chance to read this for free because it was on NetGalley for request and I got denied when I requested it. Well, I seen on my Facebook group that I belong to, a book club, and they had said, if you recently got denied for it, then just email Catherine Center and she will make it where you can still read it. And that is what I did. So thank you, Catherine Center, for making it available for me for free to read. I really enjoyed it. And I've read other Catherine Center books. They're really good. And I would highly recommend this one. Like I said, it doesn't come out until July. But this is what it looks like. 4.5 stars. It was really, really good. So yes, thank you to Catherine Center and NetGalley for a free copy. Oh, did I say when I emailed Catherine Center, she replied right back and said she would fix it so I could read it. Right? Oh my gosh. What You Wish For by Catherine Center. 4.5 stars. Pretty good. That's all I got for today, guys. If you like this video, give me a like. And hey, while you're here, give me a subscribe. And don't forget to check back for more book videos coming up soon. And one look at my shirt, which is not new. You've seen it before. I like big books, and I cannot lie. That's all I got, guys. See you later.